Welcome back to Royalty Soaps. My name is Katie Carson. I am one of the soap makers here on this channel. Sometimes I'm known as the Duchess of Suds. My brother Kenny is the Earl of Suds. He's the other soap maker here on this channel. And today we're going to be making a great soda slash intergalactic galaxy soap. It's just a lot of purple, a lot of rainbows, lots of silver. It smells amazing. The middle of this thing is gonna look a little bit weird when the soap is still raw, but after it's saponifies, things get a lot better. Also, there's a lot of weird kind of camera angles that we're trying out in this video. We have a new camera, as you guys probably already know, so we're trying to, you know, see what we can do with it. So bear with us while we experiment. And without further ado, let's make some soap. So the first thing we're gonna do is pour our lye water solution into our oils down the stick blender. Recipe I'm using today can be found in the description box below. And if you would like to get our quick mix of oils, meaning all the oils down below, but mixed into one convenient jug that you can purchase from Nurture Soap, then you can also follow those links down below. So let us blend this on high with our stick blender. For this soap, we're going to have two accent colors. So I'm just gonna pour off a little bit from our large bucket. So because this is like a galaxy grape slushy soda theme, we're gonna be using a lot of purples and some blue toned silvers. So for the first accent color, we have a little bit of antique silver mixed with celestial silver. Antique silver is from TKB. Celestial silver is from Nurture Soap. The next color is going to be one of our purples. This is Pow Pow Purple from Mad Micah's. That is so much fun to say. Correction, that is grape nahi. I don't know how to pronounce it. It's grape something. I'll link it down below. This is Pow Pow Purple, so we're gonna add that to the large container. To the large container, we're also adding some Eclipse Enviro Glitter. Look at that sparkle. This is from Nurture Soap. So first, I'm gonna mix these in with a spatula. And I mix that antique silver with the celestial silver because celestial silver has a blue undertone, which will match those purples. And now for the big one and all the glitter. I am going to stick blend these to make sure that we get the most out of those purple colors. But as you can see, they're pretty potent even without me stick blending. Caleb is going to love this soap because purple is his favorite color. The fragrance oil we're using today is Grape Soda Pop from Nurture Soap. Now, I've used this before. I have a video. It was at one time our most watched video here on this channel. It does some wonky stuff to your soap when you first mix it in, but after you let it sit, it goes away. It's another one of those paranormal activity things that happened with the colors. A paranormal color morph.
Oh my gosh, he just dumped it in.
It's the proper amount, it's been measured.
What an ugly color.
Don't you worry, my friend, it'll get much worse before it gets better. Watch this. It smells really good though. Can you smell that up from where you are?
No.
Looking gorgeous. This one's gonna be stunning. You liked that purple color? Let me make it a little better for you. There we go. That one actually doesn't look as bad. Now, I didn't actually use these colors the first time I made this soap, so I'm hoping that it does turn the right colors after it sits for a while. I'm a little concerned about this one, but you never know until you try. So, now that everything's mixed in, let's pour it into our two Brambleberry molds after this quick commercial break. So I'm gonna pour a lot of this base purple, or whatever color this is now, into our two Brambleberry molds because we don't have that much for the drop swirl, which I did do on purpose, by the way. I just didn't want as much accent color on this. I wanted all of these purple sparkles to sort of carry this soap. I'm going to put the silver, green, whatever that is, in first. And I'm dropping it from up a little high at first before I put in the next purple. And then I'll drop it from a little closer after that. I just want to do two passes. And I know it's really ugly right now. Don't be fooled. Get a little closer for this one. Just like that. And a little closer for this one.
Man, that does smell good. I can smell it now.
All right.
Grape soda. Look at that luxury color.
Oh!
Quality enjoyment for the whole family.
And now that I've scrapey-scrapied my big containy, I'm just going to add a little bit more into both of the molds, and then we will move along and begin frosting the top. And let me tell you, the frosting is going to be way prettier than this is right now, because it doesn't have any fragrance oil in it. So the first color that we're going to add is, once again, the Enviro Glitter. Super sparkly. We're also adding some of the Pow Pow Purple in there. So I have my frosting bag all filled up. It is super sparkly and it's still a little runny right now. I decided to pipe a little bit runny because I want the frosting to look really fluffy and I want to make it kind of tall. And I also want to have a lot of time to put on the drizzles and the glitters and all the pretty things I have to put on top. Now, can we all just agree that grape is in the top three for artificial flavorings? Sure, it doesn't taste anything like a grape, but it tastes really good. It's just like cherry. No, it doesn't taste anything like a cherry, but it tastes really good. You get to banana, and yeah, it tasted like bananas tasted one time, and it tastes really bad. Another good flavor is blue coconut. Blue coconut is made up. There's no such thing as a blue coconut, but that artificial flavor and those Sonic slushes are super good. At least I don't think there's such thing as a blue coconut. If there is, y'all gotta tell me, because I definitely need to know. Every time I use this piping tip, I think to myself, Katie, you should bake more. You should make more cakes and you should use that piping tip. And I tell myself, yes, Katie, that is a very good idea. And then I never do it. This purple color reminds me of a video game character and I don't know which one.
Waluigi.
Maybe that's it. I feel like there's a little dragon that looks like this. Is there a dragon video game? Is it Spyro? Look at me! Look at me! I actually know what I'm talking about. I'm pretty sure that's a 90s video game though, isn't it?
An oldie but a goodie.
Would no, never played.
Me neither, but I hear it's a goodie. They look like little creatures with those little bendy hats or something.
You saying the purple people reminds me of that horrible Harry book that Mother read to us when we were kids. It was like Horrible Harry and the Purple People Eaters, and he like crafted them out of little weird stuff that he had in his desk. You saying that too reminds me of Junie B. Jones for some reason. I read one of those books over at mine and Kenny's parents' house not that long ago. That is a very mischievous, smart child. Like, as a kid, I was just like, yeah, Junie B, always getting into trouble. And now that I read it as an adult, I was like, Junie B, what a handful.
Once you have kids, then you're like, this kid is too much.
Yes. She's like, and Mrs. heaved a very big sigh. And see, I always felt bad for Junie B. Jones. Like, oh, her teacher doesn't like her. I wouldn't either. So using some of this grape color from Mad Micah's, we're gonna do a little drizzle on top. It's nice and runny, so I want it to kind of seep into the cracks. Make sure everybody gets a little bit. This will soak right up into the soap, by the way. I've had a couple of people ask me recently, like, does that oil just stay oily? No, it doesn't. It leaves the color behind and the oil soaks in as the soap continues to sit. Next, we are putting on some large hollow glitter. This is gonna add to the whole whole, you know, galaxy feel of it. And there's never a wrong time for hollow glitter, you know what I'm saying? I'm also going to be adding a little bit of this silver bio glitter from Mad Micah's.
Just to make it even more gorgeous. I'm specifically adding this to the sides of the soap.
We're also going to add some of these silver colored salts.
Silver finger.
Silver finger.
Isn't that a woman?
Yeah, but it's Goldfinger.
Yeah, but you're not supposed to say silver finger.
Now on the top, we're going to add these gorgeous signature soap gumballs that I made with Eclipse Glitter and some ye old neon purple colorant from TKB Trading.
Every bar is going to get one. And lucky for me, this purple is a different type of purple than the piping, so they stand out really well. I don't know why grape needed to be like a galaxy inspired soap, but it just did. And a mostly purple soap has been requested a lot recently. What can I say? The people like the purple. I have such a glove problem with them getting all flappy on the tips of my fingers. So I'm gonna finish putting these little soap gumballs in. Then we're going to add the shiny silvery and white paper straws. I'm gonna spritz the top with rubbing alcohol, and then we will bring you guys in for a close-up.
So here are the grape slush intergalactic purple soaps. I haven't picked a name for it yet, as you can probably tell. They look super cool with those straws stuck in them, and that hollow glitter, yes please. So we're gonna wait 18 to 24 hours and then we're gonna come back and take a look at that hopefully beautiful inside that has transformed into a gorgeous purple after this quick commercial break. We're back! Look at him. In fact, look at this on the side. Now that looks much better than it did the other day. I told y'all it would turn purple. So I'm gonna turn this thing on the side and we're gonna line it up with Evangeline. My gosh, if it doesn't match Evangeline like perfectly. What ho? It appears I have misplaced some of these. Well, it looks like a few of them are getting the old chop. That's all right, whatever. We're gonna do the best we can and line it up. And it's still quite easy to cut. I'll take one right here out of the middle. And this is what it looks like on the inside. What the crap? What is this? It's gone in a perfect square. I do not understand, and I don't know if that's gonna go away. Once again, it appears another paranormal color morph has taken place. What even is this? I'm not even joking. It's in a perfect square. How did that happen? And I know you guys can see it because we actually have a good camera now. So it smells super amazing. Per usual, the scent is always really strong in cold process soap. I think with the next couple batches, I'm gonna add a little titanium dioxide to this gray and this purple just to make them pop even more. And once again, I have no idea if this is gonna go like and stay a square in the middle or if it's gonna turn back. Like what, like seriously, what's going on with that? But you can see the glitter all throughout the bar. It's very shiny. Oh my gosh, it's so beautimous. And then of course, there's the glitter on the top with the little soap gumball embed and our little straw. So the question of the day is, do you call it soda or do you call it pop or do you call it Coke? And yes, I know that Coke is technically a soda, but down south, everything carbonated's a Coke. And I don't want to hear anything about Dr. Pepper down there. So you'll have to let me know by clicking the I in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. There will be three options there, and you should vote. What do you call it? Let me know.
Okay, this is the biggest transformation of all the soaps I've ever done. I'm dead serious. It was brown before, people, and every time I do this, which has now been a total of two times, it never ceases to shock me that it actually goes back purple. And for this bar that I'm holding up, I did change just a little bit. Sometimes I do that. Whenever we film, I'm always filming the very first batch. And if there's something about it that I want to be like a little more vibrant, I might add a little more color in the batches to come. So this one, it's even more purple and the gray is even lighter so that this drop swirl really like
pops. It's even more popping than the one that I cut on camera. It smells so good. Seriously, the best grape fragrance of all time. If you need something grape scented, I can highly recommend this one. Be sure you do something fun for yourself today, whether that is... I'm drawing a million bazillion blanks. So I was gonna say something space themed. I almost said, do something fun for yourself, like fly to the moon.
Like fly to the moon, get out of here.
Because that's totally feasible. Get in your private spaceship and leave. If flying to the moon is not an available option for you, perhaps you should just get out a telescope and look at it from here on Earth. Either way, do something space themed and have a great day. And until next time, bye for now.